lot of the medical technology field over the last few decades has been driven by small incremental improvements. For example, I can think of hugely successful technologies where the value proposition was taking a detachment of an implant as a portion of procedure that took about 2 to 3 minutes and reducing that to 30 seconds. That was a technology that achieved hundreds of millions of dollars in sales and was hugely successful going back 10 years ago. Today's environment, it's very questionable whether that type of technology would be valued as a differentiated technology or a me-too commodity that would not achieve either higher reimbursement or incremental adoption and would have to fight for its share as a commodity product compared to the other technologies that were already in the space. And so I think that incremental innovation is much less impactful in today's environment. Breakthrough innovation can be heavily rewarded, but it needs to prove the economic and the clinical value in order to be accepted by payers and administrators. And often you're going to need to fight for incremental reimbursement. And so you need to have a benefit that is measurable and that it has sufficient magnitude that it's viewed as being clinically relevant and relevant to patients and payers. One of the things that I've recognized is that for people who've spent a majority of their career in the medical innovation arena, they're hugely invested in what's historically made them successful. So the path of least resistance is to start talking about value for products that were really designed to address a physician convenience issue or something that was an incremental improvement, but that might not measurably change outcomes of care, costs of care, and it's much harder to redesign the entire process of developing and improving the process of care. And so it's really requires a commitment to talking to a broader range of stakeholders to identify what are the needs that can be improved and then ensuring that that the technology can achieve those ends. And often in clinical trials, what we're doing today is measuring costs of care. We're prospectively planning economic analyses, which are at least as important as in the outcomes of the trial as the traditional clinical endpoints.